In this video, we're going to set up and solve a mixing problem. So suppose we're given the following problem. Suppose a 200-gallon tank originally has 100 gallons of salt water in it at a concentration of 1 gram of salt per gallon. We start to pour in 5 gallons of salt water per minute, having a concentration of 2 grams of salt per gallon. Meanwhile, we let out 3 gallons of well-mixed water per minute. What is the concentration of salt when the tank is full? So we start to attack this sort of problem by writing a differential equation for the amount of salt in grams at time t. So call it y of t is the amount of salt in grams at time t. So we're going to write a differential equation for this. So we're going to write a differential equation starting with dy dt. So that's the rate of change of this quantity. So dy dt equals the rate at which salt is going into the tank. Minus the rate at which salt is leaving the tank. So we have to find expressions for these quantities. So what's the rate at which salt is going in? That's the rate at which water is going into the tank times the salt density in that water. Similarly, for the rate of salt leaving the tank, we have the rate of water leaving the tank times the salt density in that water. So these salt densities will not be the same. OK. So let's try and fill in what these quantities are. We know that water is coming in at a rate of 5 gallons per minute. And we know that the salt density in that water is also given to us. It's 2 grams per gallon. So we've taken care of the rate of water in and the salt density of that water. So now at what rate is water leaving the tank? Well, 3 gallons per minute are going out. And then the salt density of the water going out, well, that's the tricky part. The density of salt in the tank is the amount of salt in the tank divided by the volume of water in the tank. So what's the amount of salt in the tank? Well, it's different for each time t, isn't it? So we had already decided that the amount of salt at time t was y of t. So this numerator is y of t. And now all we have to figure out, this is y of t grams of salt. So now all we have to figure out is what's this denominator? How much water is in the tank at time t? Well, that does depend on t as well, doesn't it? Because we start with 100 gallons of water, and we're adding 2 gallons every minute. Why are we adding 2 gallons? That's because we're putting in 5, but we're losing 3. So we're getting a net of 2 gallons every minute. So that's why at time t, we have the 100 gallons that we started with plus 2 extra for every minute that's gone by. So the volume of water in the tank also depends on t. So this is our expression for the salt density in the water that's leaving the tank. So if we did all of this right, the units should work out. So we can cancel out gallons here, gallons here. Gallons here, gallons here. And what we get is 5 times 2 is 10 minus 3y over 100 minus 2t grams per minute. Both of these terms had units in grams per minute. So this unit makes sense because we are expecting a rate of change in the amount of grams. So that gives us a perfectly good differential equation. Describing the amount of salt in the tank at time t. Now, if we had an initial condition to go with this differential equation, we would have an initial value problem to solve. And it turns out that we do have such an initial condition. So there's initially 100 gallons of water in the tank at a concentration of 1 gram per gallon of salt. So that equals 100 grams of salt at time t equals 0. So this is our initial condition. So we can add that to the differential equation. And here we have an initial value problem to solve. So if y of t truly describes the amount of salt in our tank at time t, then it must satisfy this initial value problem that we've set up. So we're going to solve this problem. So take a look at this differential equation. It is linear, but it's not homogeneous, it's not separable, and it's not constant coefficient. So our best guess at solving this is probably going to be the method of integrating factors. So how do we do this? Well, first, we move the term with y to the other side. So we have dy dt plus 3 over 100 plus 2t y equals 10. So the coefficient of y is 3 over 100 plus 2t. That means our integrating factor is e to some antiderivative, 3 over 100 plus 2t dt. So this is just some antiderivative. We're not going to need a constant of integration here because we just need some antiderivative, not the general antiderivative that could be all of the antiderivatives of this guy. So just some antiderivative of this. So in order to compute that, depending on your skill with integrating in your head, you might need to use integration by parts. But for now, we'll spare that part. So this is e to the 3 halves ln 100 plus 2t. Now, ordinarily, there's an absolute value inside the natural log, but there's a technical reason why when you're figuring out the integrating factor, you can just ignore that most of the time. So we're not going to address that here, but we're not going to need this absolute value. So this simplifies because 3 halves can be raised as an exponent over here, and then the e and the natural log cancel out. So we're actually going to end up with just 100 plus 2t to the 3 halves as our integrating factor. So what do we do next? We multiply both sides of the differential equation by the integrating factor. 100 plus 2t to the 3 halves times, well, I pointed to this, but we should really be multiplying this, both sides of this, by the integrating factor. So we'll have dy dt plus 3 over 100 plus 2t y, and that equals 10 times 100 plus 2t to the 3 halves. Now, the way the integrating factor is chosen, if it was computed correctly, this should always be, this left-hand side should always be equal to the derivative with respect to t of y times your integrating factor. if you want to check that you did this correctly, you can take the derivative of this guy using the product rule and see that it comes out to be this left-hand side, and see that it comes out to be this. And on the right, we just have the same thing. So the next step is to integrate both sides with respect to t. So on this side, the derivative disappears. And on this side, we actually need to compute this. So we will end up needing a constant of integration here, because that's going to be the constant of integration that appears in the general solution. So to compute this, once again, it's probably appropriate to use some substitution. But we'll skip that for now and just get the antiderivative. So this is 2 times 100 plus 2t to the 5 halves plus c. So I strongly recommend actually writing down the constant of integration right here. And the reason is this. The next step is we have to get y by itself, because we're solving for y of t. So y of t is going to equal 2 times 100 plus 2t to the 5 halves plus c all over 100 plus 2t to the 3 halves. So here's the important thing. 100 plus 2t to the 3 halves is not a constant. It depends on t. It's a function of t. So we can't absorb this into the constant c by renaming it. So that's why you need to write the constant of integration as soon as you integrate and not just tack it on at the end. That would give us a different result than the one we have here. So this is our general solution to this differential equation. So the next step is to use the initial condition and figure out what this constant of integration actually is. So we get y of 0, using the initial condition, equals 100, which equals 2 100 plus 0 to the 5 halves plus c over 100 plus 0 to the 3 halves. So if you solve for c, we should get that c equals minus 10,000. So skipping all that algebra, that's what c turns out to be. So now we actually have our solution to this initial value problem, which tells us the amount of salt in the tank at time t. OK, so we're done, because we have a solution to the initial value problem. But actually, we're not, because that's not what the question asks for. So what it actually asks for is, when the tank is full, that is, when it has 200 gallons of water in it, what is the concentration of salt in the tank? Well, we've managed to figure out the amount of salt in tank, not the concentration, at any time t. So here's what we need to know. When is the tank full? So at what time t is the tank full? And how do we figure out the concentration? Because if we get that time t, then we can surely get the amount of salt in grams. But then how do we get the concentration from that? So let's tackle these questions one at a time. So at what time t is the tank full? Well, a while ago, we figured out that the volume of water in the tank starts at 100, but then we're getting a net gain of 2 gallons every second. So this is the volume of water in the tank. And we want to find out when the volume of water in the tank is 200. It's a 200-gallon tank, so that would mean we'd have a full tank. Well, that happens when t is 50. So T equals 50 is when the tank will be full. So at that point, Y of 50 is the amount of salt in grams when the tank is full. So from that, how do we get the concentration of salt at this point? Well, that's just the density. So we have the amount of salt divided by the volume of water in gallons. So how much water is in the tank when the tank is full? That's 200 gallons of water. So this is going to be our final answer. Well, not actually. We should plug 50 in and then see what y of 50 actually is. So we'll get 2 times 100 plus 2 times 50 to the 5 halves minus 10,000 over 100 plus 2 times 50 to the 3 halves. And then, since this is y of 50, then we have to divide by 200. So I'm going to put another 200 here. So this will be our final answer. And if you plug that into your calculator, you should get something like 1.823. So just to do a sanity check, does this make sense as a concentration in grams per gallon? Does this make sense as a concentration of salt in the tank when it's full? Well, we started with a concentration of 1 gram per gallon, and we are adding water with a concentration of 2 grams per gallon. So we certainly shouldn't have an answer that's outside the interval 1, 2. So this makes perfect sense as an answer. So this satisfies the sanity check, and we can say we're done.